Let's have a butcher's and see Wagwan. Today, we are viewing an auction property. Always check the legal pack, as well as auction fees. You may have additional costs and property unforeseen problems. With this property, for example, the buyer is required to make a contribution of £127.30 towards the searches and a sum equivalent to £1,000 plus VAT towards the seller's legal costs. Yes, you have to be paying for solicitors twice. This is why all you need to read the legal pack. Free parking, there are no charges to park. We are viewing a one bedroom, one bathroom, ground floor apartment with a share of freehold. This property is about 20 to 25 minutes roughly outside of Leeds city centre. So it's far. It's like bare mileage. And the property has a garden. Not just any garden. It is a whole entire exclusive garden just for you one. Oh my days. Wow. So, property looks okay. Doesn't look like there's any massive or major works that needs doing to it at the moment. It looks like we have some storage space. And it looks like a good size storage space. So you can fit some ladders. You can fit some suitcases. Buggy. It's a good size storage. Lovely jubbly. If we put our property investor hat on, other than a new bathroom, landlords, what else are you doing to this property? Is it tenant ready? Would you also replace the kitchen? What would you do? Excuse me, please. We're coming through to the kitchen again. Doesn't look like massive amount of work that needs to be done. Would you keep the kitchen? Do you think the kitchen is decent? Would you replace the kitchen? I mean, we are used to, how shall we say, very tight kitchens. So is there anything wrong with the kitchen? Would you leave it? Like, pretty decent. Let's put our first time buyer hat on. What would you do to the property? The living room and the bedroom. Would you swap it over? It's a bit mad walking straight into a bedroom. However, it would flow better if the bedroom was the living room. You could put your table and chairs there. When you're going out to hang out your washing, it just makes sense. Maybe you would just leave it how it is and replace the bed with a sofa bed so you've got a little bit more space. But, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, oh my gosh, we have a garden. Not a balcony, not a little yard, a whole entire garden. Wow. You can sit outside, have a cup of tea, have your full English. You can maybe spend 10 minutes outside before you go to work, doing some stretching, doing some yoga. You can grow some tomatoes. Like, we're excited around here. It's not every day on minimum wage that we're going to get a whole entire garden. You can invite your nieces and your nephews over, have a little camp out. Like, come on, we have a whole entire garden. This is absolutely gorgeous. A whole entire garden. There's so much you could do here. The minute we get the 10 minutes worth of sun in this country every year, straight outside. Have a barbecue. We've got a whole entire garden exclusively for us. A whole entire garden. Wow. This is absolutely gorgeous. It's the first garden on the channel, the first proper garden on the channel. This is absolutely gorgeous. We love it. Let's see what the full asking price is for the property in the region of. Let's do the Jim Jam test. Is the local shop close enough for us to pop in our Jim Jams on a Sunday morning? Let's have a look. This property is a share of freehold, so you still have a lease, but you have a share of the freehold. So normally you'd have a freeholder, a block management company, and then your leaseholder. There's no middle block management company. You just deal directly with the freeholders because you have a share of the freehold. When you have a share of the freehold, you, in conjunction with the other freeholders, have a lot more control over the service charges. So things can get done as and when. In terms of who mows the lawns, you can get the quotes. You don't necessarily just get a bill like you're active in terms of the block management decisions beforehand. I am curious to know, however, does anybody know? Let me know in the comments. If you, let's say for example, you have 10 flats, so everybody gets 10% share in the freehold. Does it matter the size of your unit? So even if it's a one bedroom flat, you have exactly the same share as a four bedroom property. I'm curious to know that actually. The lease is 999 years and it said from May in the lease, 1967. So there's about 942 years unexpired. The ground rent is a fiver a year, happy days. The service charge is due as and when. In my opinion, it does make sense. What I would do is just to put a little bit of money aside in an account. So if any charges do come up, you're not pressing the panic button because you've been putting away a little £50, £75 a month. So you've got a bit of money there. Let's see what properties rent for and what we can get in rent. Please bear in mind, a comparables do not include a garden, because that's a little bit of luxury. The housing benefit, the local housing allowance for Leeds for a one bed is £673.14 per coming month. Under shop, not quite sure why it's closed in the middle of the day. However, walk in the other direction, there is another shop available. Let's ask the question, would you buy to live, buy to let, or does Leeds need more investment before you even think about it? Let's have a look at the sales history of the property and what did it sell for? Can we afford it? Is it in our budget?